Right now on The Will Wheaton Project. As apocalypse looms, one man's passion for sci-fi just might save us all from Wolverine's excessive X-Men breasts. The Walking Dead makeover no one asked for. And burning hot sex in Salem.
She will show us the witch.
Now, the only man who can make sense of all this, Will Wheaton.
Will Wheaton, it says so right in the title. And some of you younger viewers may know me as that guy from that poster over your aunt's bed. Aunts around the world and uncles, maybe it's time to take the poster down. It's a little weird. I can see through them. Here at the Will Wheaton Project, we are going to bring you everything science fiction, fantasy, and horror from this past week. And I do mean everything. Because who's going to stop us? Our network? They're too busy trying to figure out how to combine a shark and an earthquake. So let's get started before they realize what they've done. The movie X-Men made over $200 million worldwide this weekend, and that's before you count the millions they made in product tie-ins, including Carl's Jr., Axe Body Spray, and of course, X-Men Days of Future Pabst. The massive success wasn't a surprise, but what was a surprise was this interviewer's request of Hugh Jackman.
I know a lot of people are going to ask you about the plot of the film. Mm-hmm. Could you potentially sing us the plot of the film?
Oh, God, lady, no, do not open that door!
Wolverine comes to the rescue. He's sent back in the past.
I play the Wolfman, yes, it's quite the task. In X-Men, Days of Future Past, there's the plug.
Hail to the conquering heroes, hail.
To the Wolverines are gonna come out on May 23rd.
Look like a ball of peas and I don't keep Wolverine.
Hugh Jackman was last seen wandering the Gobi Desert singing about X-Men to cacti. Have you seen me? Hugh wasn't the only one making the rounds to promote.